the toy pack.
Welcome to the toy pack, everyone. Guess what we are doing again? This is... Ta-da! Do you know them? Well, we are opening a Barbie's blind bag. Yay! Well, but first we've got to look at this blind bag and see how beautiful it is. It's got a plasticky texture which feels like it's waterproof. And the drawings are really, really nice. And she's even got a puppy right there. And, they're both wearing lovely tiara. Oh, this is gorgeous. Look at this. Wow. She's got an orange stone on her tiara with some flowers around. And then she's got a violet stone on this purple crown tiara rather. And the whole bag is decorated with these rainbow flowers. There's pink there, blue there, yellow. And let's check out their necklaces. She's got a pink stone diamond rather with violet around the necklace is violet, and this one she's got a purple one. I want a necklace like that with a giant diamond like this. Wow, it's massive. I think this is really pretty. What do you think? Which one do you like more? I like her dress better because you see, she's got this amazing puffy design on the shoulder, on the sleeves. So, I think it's quite a very unique and stylish and dress. This one is pretty in a different way, but personally I prefer this one because I like red more than I like pink. But this one though is still beautiful because it's got sparkles all over the dress. Which one do you like more? Let's see. Well, let me know. The back is the same. Let me know which dress you like more because, you know, I really like dresses. I don't know. I'm just curious to see what you want. What you like more. And over here, she's holding a beautiful basket full of, wow, pink roses. How romantic. With a purple ribbon. I think this is so colourful. I mean, a lot of the times we think Barbie is only in pink, but actually it's not. Because this time she's wearing this gorgeous red gown with orange in the bottom instead of wearing pink from top to toe. So I think it's a good change and I like it. it's a pretty cool looking Barbie here. She's beautiful, isn't she? Yes. Anyway, you ready to open this blind bag? Count to 1, 2, 3. Ah! Let's see what's in it. Ooh, amazing. It's Harō Kiti. Yay! What is this? It's Harō Kiti breakfast set. Woohoo! Are you ready for some super awesome Harō Kiti breakfast, everyone? Let's see. There is... Is this Harō Kiti toast? Wow! Have you ever eaten the Harō Kiti toast before? I haven't, because I think this is going to be my first ever Harō Kiti toast experience. It's got a little chef's hat right there, and then, what is this? It's a Harō Kiti teapot and a Harō Kiti tea mug. That is super cool. Let's see what we've got at the back. Well, as usual, if you're under 3-year-old, you've got to be really careful when playing this with your... Make sure you play with your mommy or with your daddy, because there are lots of small parts right here, and... You gotta be careful not to put it in your mouth. okay? So there's a jam spreader. Jam? Ooh, what's your favorite jam, everyone? And, well, we'll get back to that a bit later. There's fork, egg, plate, toes. It's a Harō Kiti toes. Roll cake. I've never heard of a roll cake before. Oh, one of those. We call those Swiss roll. So this time, I think it's just in Harō Kiti they call them roll cake. But you know those spongy cake that that will roll into a cake. So yeah, that's called roll cake. That's that's quite a cool name actually. And a super awesome Harō Kiti teacup. I am so excited. And since we were talking about jam, I am going to start with this. Ooh, that's the jam. Let's see if it opens. Oops, awesome, it even opens. It's transparent jam jar. Can you see Barbie right there? Can you see my finger? Yeah. It's like I'm tickling Barbie. That's a cool jam jar because it's got some glitter. Can you see it? These little silver dots right there? Yes, they are glitter. And you know, who doesn't love glitter? We've got a glittery, sparkly Harō Kiti jam jar. And I think it's really cool. But this one is colored in red. So what flavor do you think that this jam is? Because other than just the jar color, you can tell pretty sure that it's... Ta-da! What fruit is this? Is it watermelon? Is it watermelon? Yeah, watermelon is red. I think it looks more like... That's right, everyone. It's strawberry jam. It's one of our all-time favorite jam. Cool. This is quite a good size as well, because I've seen jam jars that are as tiny as that. So I think we're all gonna have a happy full tummy after this awesome Harō Kiti breakfast. Right, now let's put the jam on the side and then let's see. Oh, that's the logo. Let's put it right there. And let's see what we've got. Ooh, that's the cake roll. So you can see the roll is right there. See the spiral? That's why it's called a roll, because you know these spiral is made out of a thin sheet of sponge cake, and when you smear cream or even jam on top of that lovely spongy light cake, I'm so hungry now talking about this. Then you roll it and roll it and roll it, then it becomes this amazing roll cake. But this one is so unique because that's right, everyone, because it's Harō Kiti roll cake. It's got an icing right here with my favorite color on top of the Harō Kiti's ribbon, and there's a slice of strawberry. And what is this, guys? This is kiwi! Yay! I love kiwi! Do you like kiwi? Have you ever tasted kiwi before? But you know, kiwi is one of those fruits where it looks so ugly from outside because it's got fluffy brown, terrible feeling skin. It's not a very good looking fruit kiwi, but then after your mommy or daddy peel it off and all this amazing green kiwi meat just come out, and then when you slice it open, there is this beautiful pattern in the middle of each kiwi slices. As you can see, these are just little dots of seeds. So I found that very fascinating that all these fruits, sometimes they look so ugly from outside, and then when you cut it open or when you peel it, they turn into this beautiful piece of just good looking thing to eat, isn't it? For example, another great example here, that is pineapple. Yes, this is pineapple. You know, pineapple, have you ever seen a real pineapple before? Other than pineapple like this, when you on the Harō Kiti cake? Well, or even pineapple from a tin, they're already yellow, right? But then when you see a real pineapple, it is quite hard. It's very hard, it's brown in shape, and there is no yellow. You can't really see yellow. It's got a brown shell, and then the leaves, the stalk is a really spiky green color. So it's one of those fruits when you remove all this spiky, ouchy skin, and you know, you ended up with this amazing, juicy, yummy slices of pineapple, and they're always bright yellow in color. Ooh, I'm so hungry just looking at this amazing cake roll. And look at this, even got this little chocolate right there. See this rainbow ones? We can see there's a blue one, there's a yellow one, pink one, brown one, white one. So, well, that's a pretty exciting Harō Kiti cake roll. Yeah, you know, I get really excited when we talk about fruits because, you know, we all should love fruits and it's just super healthy for you. And what better than having a Harō Kiti cake roll? So let's put that right next to our all-time favorite strawberry jam. And then let's... Ta-da! Ooh, I want to have a cup of tea in an amazing cup like this. It's a really cute cup. See? You know, I can drink it like that with my pinky because I think it's really sweet when we drink it like this. Like, see, look, from now, this angle, it looks like Barbie. We're having a nice cup of Harō Kiti tea. So, let's see. Let's pour some tea in. And then we'll give that, serve that to Barbie. I think she really, really enjoyed that nice, beautiful, warm cup of tea, especially when the weather is cold like this. And she hasn't got a jacket, look. I think she wants another sip. Let's try again. It's so yummy. I think it's passion fruit tea, because it's so refreshing. It's Harō Kiti tea. Oops. Oh dear, luckily there's nothing underneath or else it's just gonna get burned. Because, you know, a cup of tea is hot, so we have to drink it and handle it very carefully. And let's see if the puppy wants some cup of tea too.
I think everyone's thirsty. Yummy!
Okay, and our very fancy Harō Kiti plate. Well, this is pretty straightforward. It's nice and simple. Got Harō Kiti ribbon, cool. I think it's gonna look cooler if this one is in red or pink though, because I think the plate need a bit of extra color, you know, extra color wouldn't hurt, right? You know, extra color never hurts. So let's put it right there. And then let's see what have we got. Of course, how do we eat without nice pair of knife and fork? But it's really funny because they don't match each other. Maybe this is a, because you know, when we eat like this. So let's put it right there. This is how we eat, right? So normally, there would be a fork and a knife or a spoon, but we don't have a spoon here. Fork on the left side. Yes, this is the left side, everyone. Can you repeat after me? This is right. This is left. Let's try again. This is left. This is right. Now raise your left hand, then raise your right hand. Very good, guys. So when we eat, we normally put fork on the left side and then a knife on the right side. See, this is how we eat, okay? And what we do is a this is how we cut food. Let's take our awesome Harō Kiti egg out. Ooh, this is really unique. We've got Harō Kiti face in the egg yolk. Must be Harō Kiti's egg. This is really cool. It's even a sunny side up. You know, sunny side up egg means it looks like a sun, right? You know, like a sun right there. Yeah, in the sky. There's yellow bit in the middle and then white bit around it. That's why we call it sunny side up. And then sometimes we get a scramble egg. Do you know what scramble egg looks like? It's all in yellow color. And you know, the color of omelette. That is another type of egg. And so in the fried egg, we don't see a beautiful round shiny egg yolk like this. And it's normally all mashy, but it still tastes as good as sunny side egg, and it's as healthy as usual. We all love eggs because eggs are super healthy and they taste great with everything. And this is, it's beautiful Harō Kiti sunny side up egg. So for now, let's put her right there. Put it right there. And guys, you know what? What I like to do before I eat a sunny side egg is I, you know, put some salt and pepper. And then I taste a little bit. Ooh, I forgot to check out this fork. Let's see what's special about them. Ooh, it's got Harō Kiti sign on it. Nice. And it's got this handle as well. It's a pretty good size for my hand because I've got, as usual, I've got a massive hand. Ooh, I've got massive hand. I can cover your face. And then let's try this one. This is a tiny knife. And it's soft plastic. So, you know, both of them has got different texture. This one has got Harō Kiti sign on it. And it's got a ribbon. It's got a silver knife part. And it's bendable. See, it's very flexible, which is really impressive. And this one, it's not so bendable. And it's quite hard. Yeah. This one is way harder. Okay, so back to how I normally eat eggs. I normally just put salt and pepper, and then I do that. Left hand, girls. Left hand. Which one is your left hand? Is this one your left hand? No, this is not your left hand. This is your left hand, yeah, this one. So I'll use my left hand. I put it right there. And then I take my knife with my right hand. This is my right hand. And then I just cut it. Yes, this is how we eat, girls. You can practice at home. This is how we eat. We cut a small piece like that. And then we're like, And then when we're in the middle of the meal, we put our knife and fork in on the same side. Fork on the left, knife on the right. These are so amazing, Harō Kiti knife and fork, so we make sure that we use them correctly. So there's left side and right side. So when we're in the middle of eating, we put our knife and fork like this, because we're not finished with the egg yet. And then after we finish the first bit in our mouth, we'll cut another part. This time I'm going to try the egg yolk, so I'm going to, and then I'm gonna cut it. And when I cut it, make sure that the fork is right there, still on the food. Cut it. Just make sure you cut a small bit only, not a big piece that will fit into your mouth, okay? Because, you know, we want to eat politely. Isn't it yummy, everyone? Let's see if Barbie wants some of these. Now let's cut another small piece, just a small one, because Barbie has got a small mouth, and we don't want her to eat in a rude manner, do we? Okay, because we want Barbie to eat like a lady, because they dress so beautifully. We want them to eat like a lady, right? So there you go, we cut a little bit, we just put the fork in there, and then just a small bit, and then put it with Barbie mouth. You know what? It tastes extra special because this is Harō Kiti's sunny side up egg, and I'm eating it on Harō Kiti plate and Harō Kiti calories. Can't get any better than this, can it? So guys, when you finish eating, make sure you put these two together, put the knife and the fork together like that, and then just put it on your plate when you finish eating, okay? Same with chopstick. When you finish eating, just put it back onto your plate like that. Yeah, there you go. And you know, if you show your mommy this, your mommy is gonna be really happy to see how you eat so politely, so beautifully. And okay, let's put this knife and fork on the side, because I think our next course is coming. So let's see, let's put the Harō Kiti egg on the side. Let's see, one last thing. Is this beautiful? Awesome. If you can see, you can see the details of it. It does, you know, the on top of the Harō Kiti face, there's this small textures that makes it look like a real toes, which is really cool. And then this one, look at this. This is a another appearance of my favorite fruit, pineapple. Yes, it's pineapple, it's not banana, everyone. It's pineapple, it's yellow, and it's got this nice ring on it. So it's pineapple, not banana, not lemon. Yay! Okay, let's go for the toes, guys. Let's repeat one more time. Which one is left hand, which one is right hand? Now, first, show me your left hand. Very good. Now, show me your right hand. Very good. Now, show me both your left hand and right hand. Very good, everyone. Okay. Now, let's pick up the fork with your left hand. There you go. Very good, everyone. You're doing a great job. Now, let's pick up the knife with your right hand. There you go, everyone. So, now what do? Remember how we eat the egg? Mm-hmm. Yes. We need to eat nicely in front of Barbie because we are all ladies and gentlemen, right? We want to just put the fork onto the food, into the food. Start with the edges and then we cut There you go, cut a little bit. And then just a small piece on the fork. And there we go. Isn't it yummy? And now we're taking a break from the eating. And what do? We put it like that. Just fork on the left side on the plate and then knife on the right side. Yes, right side on the plate. And then let's continue eating. This time I am going to try to eat her ribbon because I want to get that pineapple. There you go. I'm going to put my fork onto the pineapple and then I'm going to cut it.
Yum, 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 yum. This is so yummy. Should we see if Barbie wants some? Let's put a bit of the Harō Kiti toast here.
Just a small tiny bit because remember, Barbie has got a small mouth and we don't want her to eat like a dinosaur. There you go, Barbie. What about Barbie's friend? There you go. Oh, I think the puppy's getting jealous. So I think we should get a bit of the Harō Kiti toast for him too. Cut, cut, cut. Yum, 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 yum. Oh. I think he really likes the toast. Well, guys, so we've learned something really, really important, which is how we are supposed to eat with a fork and a knife. And, you know what? We haven't eaten the fruitcake yet, so I am going to show you how we let's try it with a strawberry jam right there. But remember, guys, because we have finished eating the Harō Kiti toast, what do we have to do? It's remember with the egg, we have to put the knife and fork together and put it on the right side of the plate like that. There you go. Yeah, like that. So then when we go out in the restaurant, maybe in a Harō Kiti restaurant, the staff will know that we have finished eating. This is how they know that we have finished eating. When we have our knife and fork like that. Very good, everyone. Try to practice this at home because it's really useful. Okay, now let's start fresh again. Our perfect setup right there. There you go. Fork on the left. That is left. Knife on the right. That's it, guys. On the right with a knife. And then now let's put our awesome Harō Kiti cake roll over here.
on our amazing Harō Kiti plate. And then, open the jar and put it right there. And then now I'm going to take a knife. Just going to put some of that. See, this is how we put. There you go. Let's put some. There you are. And then now let's spread the jam. Have you ever tried to spread the jam? You know, when I spread the jam, I really like to spread it to every single bit of the toast or the cake. You see what I'm doing? See? Oh, I don't have enough jam right there. So I'm going to grab some more. I can eat as much jam as I want with this amazing, glittery, sparkly strawberry jam of Harō Kiti. There you go. Ooh, this looks so yummy. Let me just spread some yummy strawberry jam. And then... It is so yummy, my goodness. I just had a little mouthful of the strawberry right there and pineapple at the same time. Now let's go for the kiwi bit. Just a small mouthful. Oh dear, I think I just had a whole mouthful of it again. I think I just had a super big bite. So guys, make sure you eat carefully and slowly, and you know, because there's so much food, there is no need to rush. Let's try again. That's better. I can taste a bit of the roll. I can taste a bit of the cream in there. I can taste a bit of the kiwi. And then now let's move on to the strawberry side. Now I want a mouthful of that. So, this is so yummy. Now I'm gonna go for the best bit. I'm gonna try this one with icing. This is so good. It tastes so yummy. I think it tastes extra yummy because it's got Harō Kiti stuff on it. So I'm just going to I think that's it for the food, guys. Let's just remember with the Harō Kiti egg and the Harō Kiti toast, what did we do? We put our knife and fork together, and then there, we put it on top of the plate like that, so then everyone know that we have finished eating. Yep, then thumbs up for everyone if you manage to do that every single time you finish eating, okay? Barbie's gonna give you thumbs up, Barbie's friend's gonna give you thumbs up, Barbie's puppy's gonna give you thumbs up, and Harō Kiti's gonna give you a big thumbs up if you eat like that, okay? And then remember to put the jars on, all the covers of peanut butter, jam, marmalade. Remember what marmalade are, guys? Marmalade are, well, we call strawberry jam, blueberry jam, and orange jam. Not orange jam, but we call orange jam marmalade. So that's another thing we've learned today. Now let's put their cover on so then they don't go bad, or then, you know, dust and stuff won't get into them. Let's just put them back. And then, what's better than having a nice cup of tea after a beautiful Harō Kiti breakfast, yeah? Let's pour some tea. Cool. I like to do this. Just to let this tea brew a little bit. Let the smell go in a little bit. That's really yummy. I think it tastes extra yummy because I just had really, really yummy strawberry cake roll. Anyway, guys, I think Barbies has enjoyed their beautiful Harō Kiti breakfast, and I did had a lot of fun out of it too, because, you know, I've never had a breakfast made of made by Harō Kiti, so it's the best breakfast I have ever had. So make sure you like this video with both your left hand, with both your right hand, okay? Thumbs up, everyone, and leave a comment if you love Harō Kiti. Thank you for watching the Toy Park, guys. Bye!